everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I am sharing with you how we installed our subway tile backsplash to complete our kitchen remodel and renovation. So, if you have been watching my channel for a while, you know that we installed our own butcher block countertops, our own farmhouse sink, and our own faucet all in this summer. So our final step was to install the subway tile backsplash. Now, we had not done this before, so of course we went on YouTube and figured out how to do some of these installations. So we got our 3x6 subway tile from Home Depot, as well as our spacers, 1/8 inch spacers, our grout, and our Mastic to stick the subway tile up on. All right, so the first step that we had to do was sand down the walls behind the tile because we had floor tile on our walls and it was stuck on like crazy. So we had to sand that down with a belt sander, which my husband did. And then we had to fill in some of the holes that were created in the sheetrock with some mud. So after that, we were able to start installing our subway tile. Now, to do this as well, we got a wet saw from a friend, so we borrowed that. And we had a Dremel as well that my husband borrowed as well. So you don't have to go and buy all these tools. You can definitely borrow them or rent them as well. So we made sure to measure and make sure we had a straight line on the bottom, and we started on the bottom first and started cutting. So my husband cut the pieces in half so that we had every other, so we had a 3x6, and then we had half of that, and 3x6, half of that, and we started going. So problem we ran into is the bottom ones would want to slide down, so we had to hold them up and just make sure they stuck, and the spacers would fall out, and it kind of became a tedious job, but we got it done. It took about 12 hours. Blaze and our friend helped on one day, and then Blaze and myself did it the rest of it on another day. So that was finished. And so after we figured all of that out and got it all put up, it looked great. So now it was time to mix our grout, and we just went with a white grout. So to mix the grout, my husband used a 5-gallon bucket, a clean one, and put the mix in and the certain amount of water it needed. Just read the instructions on the back of the package. One problem we ran into with mixing that is that it was too dry. So we needed to make sure to have plenty of water, because when it was dry, it would just keep falling off the wall. It was so difficult to get it to stay. So we made sure to put the grout on and get it all covered smoothly. We let it sit, then we wiped it down, and then I wiped down the tiles again. And there's still a little bit of white film on the tiles, but I just need to keep wiping it down every once in a while. But I think it looks great. My husband then siliconed the edges. And one thing we still need to get and finish are our outlets. So we got new outlet covers because they were like a conglomeration of silver, white, and black. So we just went with all white. But the outlet themselves are tan, so we need to change those out. But other than that, I think it has changed the look of our kitchen completely. It looks so farmhouse style, and just, I love it. So it has been a process, but it has been enjoyable as well. If you have any questions about this, leave those in the comments below. I will try to put the supplies we used in the description box, but that is our completed kitchen renovation. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new to my channel. I do videos on simple and thrifted living, DIYs, and homemaking, and I would love to have you join my YouTube community. Also, give this a like for DIYing your own kitchen. Anyway, so that is it for today. I will talk with you in my next video. Have a blessed and wonderful day. Bye.